Yo, what's up? Mark from Ramen Excels, back with a new video. This is some kind of rambling about the Forta Rock Festival, which I've been last weekend, actually Saturday. It was 2 days, but I only went the one day, the Saturday. It was Friday and Saturday, Forta Rock. I only went one day because Friday I had to work, so awesome day. I really have a great time. My girlfriend also, even though she only came for one band, I came actually for more bands than one, so I technically speaking I have enjoyed the bands more than she did, but she had a good time and I have a great time. Met some nice people too, having nice beers, drinks, having some nice food, enjoying some really good music. Had a pretty good time. We went there by the metal bus, which actually you could buy that through the Forta Rock site, and you can go to the festival, so you don't have to drive or take a train or whatever, just in the bus at your town and dropped off at the festival. And yeah, if you go back, picked up in front of the festival and go straight back to your town. So it was really really nice experience. Some nice people on the bus too. The seats could have been more comfortable because short people don't have really a problem, but if you are above 185 or something, then you get pretty tight in the seats because there's not a lot of leg space. So that was a bit bummer, but we could make it up going in the way back home. There was not a lot of was space free, so I took just one bench and could lay out my legs in total length. So that's was something better than the way to the festival. Really nice, organized. You could buy your own food and drinks in the bus and your own music even if you wanted to. So it's pretty nice. The festival, I've seen a lot of bands on the festival. I tried to see as much as possible, but there was some, something you can, unedible, something, some bands were playing at the same time, so that got a bit hard to see them both. With one, two bands in the same time, by one time, I managed to do that, but couldn't do that three or four times, so I saw Mantar, I saw Vuur, I saw Tyr, I heard some Dragon Force, saw Igor, Avatar, Baroness, For Iron King. Baroness and For Iron King was one of the bands that were playing at the same time. I just saw one half of the show of the other band, and then of one band, and then the other half of the other band. That's how I did that. I saw Illstorm a bit, Satyricon I have seen, Opeth, and I saw Nightwish. I didn't saw Mishuga or Dol, because we wanted to stay, have a good place at the Nightwish, before Nightwish started. So after Opeth we stayed at the main stage so we could get a good place to see Nightwish and good, have a good look on the podium. didn't really bother me as well. I like both bands, Mishuga and Dol. I didn't really miss them on the festival. I heard the music of Mishuga on the background because The tenth stage is kind of on the other side of the festival. So there are so like this is one stage and there's the other. So you could hear it a bit. Dol was a totally another stage, so we couldn't hear that. So doesn't matter. First band I saw was Mantar. Really nice band, a kind of mixture of Motorhead sounding with Dark Throne and Asphyx. That's the kind of sound you can expect from that band. Raw sounding, mixture of black trash and death metal and with some rock and rollish vibe to it. And some screaming vocals. That's a bit how the band sounds. It's a German duo. I didn't know them, but yeah, it sounded pretty good. So yeah. I managed to stay and look for a while, then I think I saw three songs or something, and then I went out to get some food, and I'm luckily glad that I did that. It's always good before drinking, you get something in the stomach, of course, but also after we have eaten the food, it became more crowded, there were more people getting food, so we were just in time before there was a row, so that's pretty cool. It's pretty strange, but you have to have with a lot of things. Also, if you go to the supermarket, you just not basic point, and then after us, supermarket full. That's kind of weird stuff, it happens a lot of with both of us, so yeah. If you go get to a snack bar, same deal, just in time, and then after us the snack bar gets stacked with people. That's always how it goes. I don't know why, but probably choose the right time or something. Anyways, had some nice food, some nice fries, some biological self-made fries, that kind of stuff. Tasted pretty good. Then we saw Vuur, the band of Anneke van Giersbergen, the heavy band of hers. She also have more softer music with the solo projects, but this band focus on more on metal, but more progressive metal. Pretty nice concert, but I think their own songs are not really memorable or something. I don't know. It's good, but it doesn't grab me anyway. I have to say, live it gets me more than on the album. That is for sure, because it's a good live band. But yeah, I really like that that Vuur was also playing two Gathering songs. If you don't know the Gathering, go look it up. It's the first band of Anneke. That she was in. They're pretty big in the Netherlands. Amazing band. And she played some two classic songs from that band, and I really enjoyed that. So yeah, I was really happy to see have seen Vuur. Next up, the band I saw was Tear. Some folkish, heavy power metal-ish band. I enjoyed it, but after a while I have seen it for a while and went to the metal market. Actually, I was a bit disappointed with the metal market. I was expecting some more than I saw here. Of course, there were some nice shirts and some jewelry and stuff like that. Some patches. A lot of vinyl, but I wasn't here there for that kind of stuff. I just want to buy some CDs. I managed to grab a few, but that later in the video. But I noticed one shop owner has three stands. So what you get, three times the same stuff, same prices. And there were only five or six stands that were selling CDs. So that's pretty ridiculous. A kind of monopoly position, if you ask me. Yeah, the other stands didn't have a lot what I liked. So I bought a CD of the one of the free stands of the guy of Dr. Steele. That's the mail order of the seller that was there. I managed to grab a cool album. Later on, I went to the Artscroft stand and I grabbed a few albums on that stand for a nice price, and also got the Decades a compilation of Nightwish for my girlfriend, so she could get that signed on the festival, because there were also some signing sessions there. Overall, I bought only three CDs, which I will show you later in videos, for myself, and one for my girlfriend, of course. I hear during we also hired a locker there, so we put off the stuff in there that we bought, and our bags and stuff like that. And then on the way we saw some bit from Dragon Force. Dragon Force is a band I listened to in the past, long, long time ago. Not much. It's nice if you like that kind of genre, but I get bored with that band pretty fast. That's what I think. Not that they're bad or something, but the fast power metal with the high screams and a lot of appealing guitars is not my kind of music. Not back then, really, and now not completely not anymore. I heard it on the background, but I think it's not bad. But it's not something I listen to, which I prefer or something. Luckily, we saw after that a really nice concert of Igor. Igor was really amazing, really amazing friends, guys, and girl. It's actually three guys and one girl. One is a DJ, which is Igor himself. Guy on the drums and a male singer and a female singer. That's what you get on the stage. I have to say, the male singer looks pretty weird. Some kind of folkish war paint, blue, white, black on his face, a lot of powder on his body, and a weird costume. That's what you get with those. But the music, on the other hand, is really, really interesting. If you don't know Igor, they call the sound baroque core, which actually is a mixture of how do you call that? Gabber music, hardcore music, not the punk hardcore, but the electronic hardcore, combined with death metal, black metal, some baroque music, some opera stuff, really weird kind of mixture, but it works. Diversity in styles all through the set. Some people laughed and some people enjoyed, danced, whatever, sang along with that. I really can enjoy it, this band. I've seen this band before. I was not impressed on that concert, but this concert was pretty impressive. I enjoyed it. Really nice stuff. Next thing I saw was a bit from Avatar. Haven't seen the whole concert, but a lot of big parts of it, because my girlfriend was standing in the line for the signing session, and that was next to the main stage, and Avatar was performing on the main stage, so I saw that there. I'm not really familiar with Avatar, but I can't say it's bad. Not kind of music I put on myself at home, but if I'm at a concert or bar or whatever on the car, I really wouldn't mind to hear this kind of music. Pretty nice Yeah, how do you call it? Hard rock stuff. So Weird acts also with a nice, well-dressed stage, costumes. Yeah, really try to make something of the gig. Some songs were catchy as hell. So yeah, you can almost sing along if you know the words. You could sing along pretty straight away. So yeah, it was catchy. It was nice to see. Really nice performance. Not my typical kind of band I would listen to, but yeah, I enjoyed the gig. Girlfriend was still in the line for a signing session of Nightwish because the line was fucking huge. Luckily, she went pretty early to the row, so she was not completely in the back and would get disappointed. But I sure were people that were get that deadly disappointed. Signing was about around 5 o'clock or something. She was already standing there. Don't know, 3:45. I don't know, something like that. Yeah, a really long wait, and the signing was until 6 o'clock, and then the other bands will get the signing. So probably some people would get disappointed, but she got some signatures on her Decade CD, so she was really happy with that. So I'm glad for her that she has done that. And in the meanwhile, when she was at the signing session, I was going to see Baroness in the 10th stage, and Baroness fucking killed it. Really amazing gig. Really nice progressive sludge metal, if you don't know the guys and girl. Amazing band, straightforward but still a bit progressive and also catchy and with some chorus lines and stuff like that. So it could pretty stuck pretty fast in your head as well, not only with weird freakery and you don't remember at all. Yeah, the songs are memorable, really nice to hear, really nice vocals, nice guitar riffs. Really nice performance, and she did really well. So halfway I went of course to the theater stage, which was the third stage on the festival. I saw, I think, two and a half songs from I Am King, a band from Amsterdam if I'm not mistaken, but they're from the Netherlands anyway, if I'm get the place wrong, but anyway, they are from the Netherlands. Amazing metalcore band, female fronted, and really great sounding riffs, good quality vocals. Yeah, and actually the crowd went nuts there. Big mosh pit in a little room, a lot of people watching, stage dives, crowd service, people went all nuts, crazy. Yeah, I think they gave a good performance, judging on the reactions from the crowd. Yeah, I really liked what I hear too as well. Pretty good band. Definitely gonna go look up some more from this band. So yeah, I wasn't really familiar with them, but it was nice get to know. So yeah, really cool performance. Then I heard and saw a bit from Illstorm, which was also really weird stage performance as well. Really big duck on the stage, like which you do in the bath, that kind of duck. You know, so that kind of yellow ones. Only like 4 meters high or something, I don't know. Yeah, with costumes, because Illstorm is some folky pirate metal. Yeah, interesting, really happy tunes, fast paced, nice to sing along on a festival or something. Definitely not a band I'm playing at home, but for a festival, I like this kind of music as well. So yeah, I enjoyed the gig, of course. Amazing, get the crowd pumped up again. Yeah, can nothing say more from nothing more, but respect for the guys. Nice performance. Of course, then the bands I came for, which was Satyricon, that was the main band I wanted to see because I have never seen Satyricon live. I know for a black metal fan, but yeah, they played fucking awesome. Nice songs. Not too much from the new album, actually. A lot of older stuff, not completely old, but stuff like King, that kind of stuff. We also, of course, played Mother North, which was a really a song I wanted to see, and they played it live. Yeah, you couldn't go wrong there. Really nice performance, fast paced, and also some slower songs, some up-tempo songs. Yeah, nice mixture. Gladly they played only an hour, so otherwise you would play with a lot of more stuff. But yeah, they have only an hour, so yeah. Was nice performance. Really glad I've seen them. And they actually made a comment on the stage. Sutter made that one. They played in 2009 or something. And why now after 9 years? No, why not earlier? But yeah, I understand that. But to come back there on festival. But yeah, I was really nice. I really enjoyed the performance. Great lighting, great set list. Sound was not bad either, and Oli was a bit loud, but nonetheless, I really enjoyed that set. One of the highlights of the day for me, of course. Then we went out to see the band Opeth. Something of the band I've seen a lot of times before, now a lot more times before. Actually, I was a bit disappointed with this performance. I don't know why. So I think it's they were not passionate about it or something. They had. It felt like they didn't want to play there or something. I don't know. Of course, there were some weird jokes like Michael Akerfeldt always does, but the band already started too late, and they were surprised that they have to scrap one song. Yeah, guys, start on time, then you can play that song. So yeah. You have made a playlist, and if you're not starting at the right time, you're missing a song. And if you stay longer away or stop earlier, you're missing some more. So that's not really strange. You only have the time to play. I think they have at the time to play 1 hour. They didn't do that. I think they played like 53 minutes or something. Something in that vein. So yeah, they must have scrapped one song. I wonder what that was. They called it the best song they ever made, and you couldn't play that song, so you just play some other shitty songs. That was a bit kind of what he said. Funny in a way, but felt a bit like disappointed from them, and they didn't want to play anymore. Something that is how I felt it a bit. And that you could see it also a bit. They were not enthusiastic. Yeah, it's like there was a kind of routine, but not. Yeah, enthusiasm was not there. It's like a duty or something they have to do, or something they must. But guys, you don't have to play there. If you want to play live, it's sometimes shit happens, so yeah. You still have to perform. Contract is contract. Although they played some nice songs, not too much from the last two albums, because those two albums I don't like. If I want to hear 70s rock, I put out some something different, some Pink Floyd or something, I don't know, or Deep Purple, whatever, not Opeth. But they played some older songs. But yeah, I was still wondering what they would have played if they had the time for that one song. Probably Demon of the Fall, I think, but you never know. Also played Deliverance as last song. What the fuck they play more? I can't recall the song. A song from Blackwater Park. And another other heavier song. And one or two from the later work. That's actually what they played. Not much songs, but you know Opeth, they have pretty long, lengthy songs. So yeah, that was not really strange. So yeah, a kind of disappointment for me with that gig. They could have made it a better gig, but it was not there in a way. Yeah, and then the long wait, like I said earlier, then we waited for Nightwish. Nightwish performance was amazing. There was some kind of beautiful, some kind of little mistakes, like the flute work and some kind of, in the beginning of the gig, some, and the end of the gig, some vocal lines that Floor didn't get, like the last high note in last song Ghost Love Score was not perfect. She have done that better. It was not bad, but like she was a bit tired or something, I don't know. She couldn't make it in a way or straight to the top. She came far, of course, but overall the vocal performance was pretty good from Floor Jansen, so that was amazing. They played a lot of old songs as well, and I was really surprised. 10th Man Down, Come Cover Me, they played Gethsemane, what they have played more, the Devil in the Deep Dark, Old Ocean they have played from Oceanborn. Yeah, that kind of stuff. Of course, also some newer stuff, even the Amaranth, which was originally sung by Annette Olson, they have played that one. Nemo they have played, End of All Hope they have played, kind of songs. Of course, The Greatest Show on Earth was one of the last, the second to last song. Last song was Ghost Love Score. Really nice set list, nice performance, nice big show. They always do a lot of firework, fire, projection screams, stuff like that. It was all there. A bit light show. Yeah, really great performance. Yeah, they also gonna play in Ziggo Dome in November. We also go to see them there. Hope what they're gonna do then with the set list. Hope is then a kind of not the same, but it would be pretty cool if they also did some other songs or they changed up a lot of things. It would have been pretty weird if they played the same set list. They played a 1 hour and a half on Fortarock. Probably they played 2 hours on their own gig, probably something like that. So there could be four more in the gig then. But anyways, a nice headliner for the Saturday. I'm really glad that I went there. Although I was a bit disappointed that they moved Creator from Saturday to the Friday, but doesn't matter. I have seen Creator more live, but so I will stop bitching about that. But yeah, really nice day, had a great time, have nice food, nice drinks, nice people, nice gigs. enjoyed my time there, so yeah, really nice time. Then of course, like I said, I bought some CDs, so I'm gonna show those now. First one I bought at Dr. Steel, like I said, this is Melvin Creation with Stillborn. I saw that for a really cool price and thought, let's buy that one. Melvin Creation is of course a cool death metal band from the USA. Really nice death metal, third album, released in 93 I think. Yeah, the first three albums are the best in my opinion, and of course I really like Envenomed, which is a really great album. Not that they're all bad, but those three are the best, and this is album number three, so yeah. Great to have them in my collection. I have now a lot of 6 or 7 albums by them. So yeah, I'm really glad that I could add this to my collection. I really like the artwork as well. Really, really cool. Back again, and hope it focuses a bit. Roadrunner Press of this album, really great. They also have released this not so long ago through another label, which was a Digipack, if I'm not mistaken. But yeah, I really glad I could grab this in a jewel case. Amazing death metal, Malevolent Creation with Stillborn. At Artschok stand, I grabbed a few CDs. This is Vesperian Sorrow with Psychrotic Sculpture, which is their second album. This is a US symphonic black metal band. A really amazing stuff. Released by Displeased Records. The year escapes me a bit, I think early 2000s or something like that. Yeah, really amazing band. If you're not familiar with this, go check them out. I think Lonnie Shewell mentioned them a lot before. And he's right, go check it out. Great band. I already knew this band, but didn't have material by them. And now I have, so I'm really glad I have this album. Great stuff. Go check out the Vesperian Sorrow with Psychrotic Sculpture. Last one is a 2018 release. I bought this very fucking cheap compared to the normal mail orders and CD shops. I only paid half price for this, so I'm happy. This is the new Memoriam with the Silent Vigil. Yeah, second album by this UK, the old school death metal band. If you like bands like Thrower, then this is your thing. Great stuff. Nice digipack here and there. Yeah, I really enjoyed this. Great bands. I also have the first album on vinyl, and I'm glad to have this one as well. Great add to my collection, and really will enjoy this. That's the whole idea. I didn't buy something else, yeah, food and drinks, but yeah. Anyways, really nice day, like I said, and I really liked the stuff. If you want to see some live footage, I will leave a link in the description. I also made a live footage video with a lot of bands on my channel, so you can watch that. Also, we'll leave links to the albums I show you, so you can listen to them. I'm going to end the video now. After this rumbling of mine, there will be some pictures as well. You can watch that one before you get the ending credits. So I would like to thank you for watching, liking and subscribing. Please also check out the Facebook page, website and my Instagram. Links will be in the description down below. If you want to say something, just put it down there in the comment section. That's it. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed this video and the live footage I showed you. And hope to see you guys with the next video. Thank you. Take care and have a nice day. Ciao.